It's hard to believe that we've already been at General Conference, at least those of us in Global Missions, for over a week. In fact, we started on last Friday, a week ago today, with our Global Missions Board meeting. Many great decisions. We have decided to meet a few couples, several couples. There were also missionaries that were upgraded. Also, there was a new missionary appointed, Sister Karen Poole, who is an intermediate missionary that will be going to Lesotho. And I thank God that we have had a tremendous, tremendous week. I thank the Lord because also we were privileged to meet the ladies and the youth to ask for allocations for our missionaries. The ladies help with appliances and student training, and I'm glad to report that they gave us a record offering of over $600,000 to help us this coming year. And then the youth ministries, I'm thankful for the vehicles they buy and then other ways to move the gospel, helping MK Ministries, Next Steps. They gave us $1.2 million plus to help us in global missions. Thank you so very much to those two ministries that help us tremendously. Glad to report that on Tuesday night in the North American Mission Service, there was a tremendous blessing there and also an outpouring of a burden to reach cities and also to reach towns for Christ. Then on Wednesday, we held our business session. I'm honored to have been reelected as the General Director of Global Missions. Brother Bernard was reelected as our General Superintendent. Daryl Johns is our new Assistant Superintendent. Brother Gleason was elected, reelected as Assistant Superintendent. And I won't go down the list of everyone else, but we had a tremendous business session. There were two resolutions from Global Missions, and we're glad that that is positive, what's happening with that. But on Wednesday night, we had a tremendous service with three preachers. The altars filled with literally hundreds of young people, and not just young people, but hundreds of people giving their lives to God to serve in global missions. We're thankful because there will be many missionaries that will come out of that. But along with that, there was $1,706,000 pledged. I'm glad to report to you that we have now $699,000 in cash of that offering, and we sent seven families back this week. As the cash comes in and as people send their pledges in, if we are able, we will see that much, I know, and probably more, but we will send eight more families back to the field, and we rejoice with that. Also glad to say that there is a tremendous blessing of what's going on. On Thursday, there was a children's ministry service where 32 children were filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Last night, our general superintendent ministered to us. And then this morning we had a youth ministries meeting, and then tonight there will be a crusade. Well, I know probably you knew about all that, but I wanted to tell you we've had a great conference, and it's all about the whole gospel to the whole world by the whole church. Let me simply say that I thank God that the future of global missions is tremendous. Let me tell you a little testimony of something that happened this week. Brother and Sister Driggers, who are missionaries to Spain, were coming to church on Wednesday evening in their rental car when they had a flat tire. They were in a rental car. They could not leave it. So they began to try and get a tow truck to help them. They called one insurance company. They finally got another insurance company. They finally got a tow truck to come out. He was not able to come to church. She came on to church, but he had to stay with the vehicle. And when he did, the man that was the tow truck driver of the second tow truck that came, I want you to know, he said, "I'll give you a ride back." And as he did, Brother Driggers began to witness to the man. And as he began to witness to the man said, "I've been in some studies and they've been visiting me from a cult." And he said, "I don't understand it because they don't really use the Bible." And Brother Driggers began to tell him about the gospel, tell him about Acts 2:38. And I want you to know, in the cab of the truck, the man repented of his sins, raised his hands, and God filled him with the baptism of the Holy Ghost in the truck. Hallelujah. That's what missions is all about. And I'm glad to tell you that around the world it's happening. What is the future of global missions? The future of global missions is one word, evangelism. We have 11 countries where we do not have a UPCI work. And I want you to know that is our goal, is to reach those countries. But not only those countries, it's our goal to reach unreached people groups that are not just limited to a geographical area. We now have a study and an experiment going on, and before long we'll be launching something that will be very interesting about reaching unreached people groups around the world. I'm glad to tell you that also Global Church Initiative, a global church growth initiative is taking place, because our number one word in global missions is evangelism. That's what we are here about, reaching the whole world with the whole gospel. We also want to strengthen our present works. Also, we want to see more missionaries appointed from North America, and we know God is going to do that through our short-term programs. Also, we want you to know the future is about other countries appointing missionaries. In fact, I think I may have mentioned it one day, maybe I did, but I want to tell you right now that when we came to conference, there were 11 countries that didn't have it, but just a few weeks before that, there were 12. But because of Madagascar sending a missionary to Mayotte, they were able to get their visa, and now I'm glad to tell you we are starting a brand new work in the country of Mayotte in Africa. God is blessing the church, and that's the future of global missions. We also want to see the training of our national pastors in administration. It's our goal to help our missionaries and facilitate them to reach the countries and the people where they are. We also, this week, approved a brand new region. I'm glad to report to you, yes, we have formed a brand new region. We've had 6 regions for many years, but now we have separated Europe and the Middle East. We have the Europe region, and now we have Eurasia and Northern Africa as a new region. We will be appointing a new regional director in February of this coming year. And I want you to know great things are happening. It's all about evangelism. Did you hear me? It's all about evangelism. It's about reaching a soul that doesn't know the Lord Jesus Christ. We'll be setting goals. We've got the global council that, the Lord willing, will be meeting here in St. Louis next year. We have not been able to meet for the last 2 years, but we're believing God to help us to have the global council. Well, it's exciting what's going on in global missions. And number one goal of global missions is reaching the world with the gospel. I'm thankful for this week, and that's what's going on. And I thank you. I'm sorry you weren't able to be with us, but I want you to know you are with us in our heart, and may God richly bless you this afternoon.
It doesn't matter how much rain falls, the sun will shine again. It doesn't matter how much the wind blows, there will be peace. There will be laughter after this. Yes, weeping may endure for a night, but joy will come in the morning, and I can live through the night.
It says the voice of the Lord maketh the hinds to calve. Okay. What does that mean? I found out this is what it means. There are times where the thunder is so loud, where the voice is so strong, that what the psalmist was saying was, when that kind of thunder hits, pregnant hinds begin to cast their young. Watch this. It's unexpected births. It's unexpected births. I just feel like we're going to begin to see some unexpected births all across the world.
We'll be sending back up to 15 families completely to go back to the field.
Though we had nothing to do, with the establishment of the church handed up. We have everything to do with where this church